Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol and we are going through a series of videos on activities. Today we are going to take a look at the activity calendar. Once you log into Method to find the activity calendar, you just go to the Activities tab and all the way to the right of the tab links you will find Activity Calendar. As the name suggests, the activity calendar is a calendar of your activities. And if you're familiar with any calendar app, this should not be too difficult for you. In the top, we can change the filter views. For example, here I can see activities assigned to different people. Right now it's assigned to me and I can check May and then apply the filter. Over here you can change the status filter so you can select which statuses show up in the calendar. By default, it's set to all statuses, whether you check the checkbox or not, but I'm gonna check the checkbox for just to show you. On the right, we can change the view, whether it be by work week, day view, month view. And on the left, these arrows will go forward and backwards within the calendar, depending on the view that you've chosen on the right. And finally, you can also change it right here and select a range of dates that's customized. So maybe I only want to see the first 4 days. There we go. Okay, right click. I'm going to refresh this so that I can get back to my default view. One thing you should realize is that not all activities will show up in the calendar. It is dependent on activity type. And I cover this in more detail in the activity types user tutorial video. Anyway, here I am back in the month view, and you may notice there is a color coding, which makes it look like, Monopoly. If you take a look at the status, you notice that we have a color code here. So red means it's not started and green means it's completed. I'm going to close that filter so we can see the whole calendar. This symbol here means it's a recurring activity. And if you've noticed anytime I've mouse overed any one of these activities, it will show you a wonderful small pop-up bubble of information. If I click this greater than sign, I can choose to edit the activity series, and or refresh the calendar. This one has a series associated with it. If I were to click that, I would be able to see the series. I'm gonna close that. And if I were to click, for example, the activity, then I would find the actual activity that I clicked on. And obviously, if I want to refresh the calendar, I just click refresh calendar. One last thing you can do in the calendar is create a new activity. If I were to press Friday and this greater than little button pops up and I click it, I can do a new appointment. And this will automatically choose Friday for me. The whole day, in fact, 12, 24th, 12 a.m. to 25th, 12 a.m. But if I want a specific block of time, let's go to a work week view. Now I'm gonna scroll down. Where do I want to have a meeting? Let's make the meeting next week. On Monday, I'll have a 9 o'clock meeting, 10 o'clock meeting, let's make it. I'm gonna click and drag it for an hour. When I let go, I should be able to get the greater than symbol. If I click that, I get new appointment. Now it will automatically fill in that I have a meeting on May 27th from 10 to 11 a.m. I'm gonna save and close that. And there it is. Woo, my meeting. And that's it. That's the activity calendar. If you have any questions, by all means, you can leave comments in the YouTube down below or tweet us at @methodcrm. I hope you have a great day and take care. Bye-bye.